Cyber warfare is playing an increasing role in the conflict between Israel and Hamas. Earlier, I spoke with Erel Margalit, who heads the tech fund Jerusalem Venture Partners. We began by discussing how the latest hostilities are affecting Israeli businesses.
Well, you know, Israel built its high-tech industry, the startup nation, as it's called, when we had two wars in the Gulf, two intifadas, a war in Lebanon, and a war in Gaza. So I can say that the high-tech industry in Israel was built at times which were not easy. Having said that, obviously it's a bit challenging. We are continuing. We are making new investments. We are having new partnerships with international companies. So things are moving forward, but obviously we'd like to put this current affair behind us.
Mr. Margalit, the Israeli finance minister, Yuval Steinitz, says that since the Gaza operation began, there have been 44 million cyber attacks on official Israeli sites, and all but one of the attacks have been stopped. How easily were these sites breached?
Well, you know, since he said that, there's actually over 60 attacks on Israel. And, you know, cyber warfare and cyber defense is one of the things that we do in some of our companies. So we have a little bit of experience from that, both in terms of the military, but also from the civilian standpoint. So, yes, I think people need to be aware of this because it's not just going to be Israel. There's a massive attack on Israeli sites right now, and it's coming both after sites which are official news sites, but also after infrastructure sites, whether it's security, utility, banking systems, the airlines. These things are mission critical organizations that people are trying to hack. And we are seeing that the Hamas is backed by other organizations in trying to penetrate these sites. And one needs to have a new paradigm of cyber defense in order to meet these kind of threats.
Sir, a McAfee study rates Israel as one of three countries best prepared to withstand digital attacks. The other two countries are Finland and Sweden. How does that expertise help companies like JVP recruit investors and make inroads in a cybersecurity market that's near $20 billion?
Well, you know, just like Israel today has a dome to protect from an iron dome to protect from the attacks of the missiles, Israel today needs a cyber dome in order to protect from the cyber attacks. Now, Israel was responsible for the invention of the firewall, the antivirus, and a variety of additional kind of products that are used around the world today for cyber defense. But the world needs a new paradigm, and banks need to be aware of this, utility companies, governments, and other organizations. Because if you had a wall, a firewall is a good metaphor, or the Maginot Line, if you remember in World War II, that wall is now penetrated, it is broken. You need a new paradigm. You need a paradigm to be able to intercept the kind of attacks that are happening from within. And that's what I think a lot of Israeli companies and Israeli products could be relevant for other organizations. And today, what we are doing is we are implementing those kind of new ideas into a center of excellence of the country that is actually going to be opened in Be'er Sheva, which is being attacked. And we're going to create a variety of new products, new companies that are going to come up with a new kind of paradigm for the next generation of cyber defense.
Sir, JVP has founded several successful companies in the cybersecurity field, most notably CyberArk, which sold a stake to Goldman Sachs back in December. Are we starting to see more cooperation between military and technology companies in the field of internet security?
Yes, you know, it wasn't sold. JVP invested it, created the company. Goldman Sachs joined us with a major investment. And now we're on the road to create CyberArk as one of the new companies that are going to be massive, so we hope, in cybersecurity.
And that was Erel Margalit of Jerusalem Venture Partners. He's also running for the Labor Party in Israel's parliament.